The geometry display in SimCenter Test Lab is used to display models and animations, often mode shapes or operational deflection shapes. To create a geometry display, press Create a Picture, and then select Geometry. To display an animation, you'll need to do two things. First, drag the geometry into the display, and then add an animation, such as a mode shape. Once the geometry is in the display, the view can be manipulated by panning, zooming, or rotating. To pan the model or translate it, press the button on the far upper left and keep the button depressed while moving the mouse to translate the model. To zoom in and out, press the adjacent button and keep the mouse depressed while moving the mouse to zoom in and out. You can also use the scroll wheel to zoom in and out of the model. Finally, to rotate the model, click and drag in the viewer to visualize different angles. Of course, with all this manipulation, you might get kind of a funny angle. It's easy to snap the view back into the display by right-clicking and selecting Fit Model. It's also easy to snap back into a view by right-clicking, selecting Views, and then selecting one of these preset views. Let's hit Isometric. There are also lots of visualization options. For example, it's possible to change the background color by right-clicking, selecting Options, and then under the Background tab, it's possible to change the upper and lower part of the gradient. I'll change both of these to white. Oftentimes, this is a good option if you're exporting a shape to a report. I'll also change the text color to black. Other visualization options include turning on markers, names, Euler angles, etc. If you right-click in the display, the same options appear under Deformed Model and Undeformed Model. I'll turn them on the Deformed Model. So under Nodes, I'll turn on Markers, and now you can see each individual node. I can also turn on the Names, which have the scheme of the component followed by the node number. And finally, I can turn on Euler Angles. To make it look a little cleaner, I'll turn these back off as we talk about the next options. It's also possible to represent deflections with color. If you right-click in the geometry display, under Coloring, you can select Enable, and this will add coloring to represent the deflection. Under that same coloring menu, there is the Edit option under Scale, which allows you to choose different color schemes. I'll turn coloring back off for now, though. To control the way the animation is played, right-click, and under Animation Settings, there's options to change the delay as well as the frames per cycle. Delay is the time in milliseconds between frames of the animation, so by decreasing the delay, the animation will cycle faster, and by increasing the delay, the animation will cycle slower. Let's just show the difference between 50 and 10 milliseconds. You can see how much faster it's moving now. Under Frames per Cycle, we can control the number of frames that are used to represent the animation. So the less frames, the more choppy the animation will look, and the more frames, the smoother it'll look. So let's do an example with just 6 frames. You can see how much more choppy the animation looks. If a geometry has multiple components, some components may hide the movements of others. For example, I want to see the bottom of this geometry, but it's being hidden by this body component. To turn off the visualization of certain components, right-click, come under Component Visualization, and under the Visibility tab, check and uncheck different options. So here, by turning off the body, I have a much better view of what's happening on the other components. Once you're happy with the way the animation looks, it's possible to export it as a video, GIF, or active picture. To do so, just right-click in the display, select Export to Video, and then choose your location and name, and then choose to save as either a video file or a GIF. It's also possible to export as an active picture. If you export as an active picture and then copy and paste that into a Microsoft program, after double-clicking on the picture, it will begin to animate. Check out the article below for more detail on these geometry display options.